Welcome back to the American Diabetes Association's 75th Scientific Sessions. I'm Rhonda Anderson with another update from the Boston Convention and Exhibition Center, where we are hosting the largest diabetes meeting in the world. Over the past 50 years, almost everything has changed for Americans with diabetes, from how they test their glucose levels to how long they can expect to live. A special symposium held today took a look at all the progress we've witnessed, featuring speakers who have lived with diabetes, researched it, and treated it for 5 decades or more. Long ago, the only option for treating type 1 diabetes was to inject animal insulin, which came from cows or pigs, and sometimes caused adverse reactions. Today, we can produce human insulin in a lab. Not only are there fewer bad reactions, but there's no fear of running out. What's more, we now have long and rapid-acting insulin and a variety of delivery systems. This includes insulin pumps, which improve accuracy and comfort while tightening blood glucose control and reducing hypoglycemia or preventing dangerously low blood glucose levels. The way glucose levels are tested has also changed dramatically. It used to be that the only way to measure diabetes control was to test for sugar in a person's urine. Today, there are numerous, far more accurate ways to test, including the A1C, which measures blood glucose level over a 3-month period. And then there are the advancements in diabetes-related complications. Until 1993, when the Diabetes Control and Complications Trial Study was published, complications such as eye and kidney disease were thought to be the result of diabetes rather than high blood glucose levels. Now we know that prolonged high glucose levels increase the risk for these and many other diabetes-related complications, and that maintaining tighter control of blood glucose levels reduces that risk. Researchers' understanding of diabetes has also grown, including how it develops, how to prevent or delay it, and how it affects the rest of the body. All of this was virtually unknown in the 1960s. That tells us that the fruits of scientific investigation don't ripen overnight. In order to understand a disease, you have to do basic research, and it takes a long time for that research to have real-world impact. Think about it. The diabetes drugs we use today were first studied 30 to 40 years ago. There's been a lot of change over the last 50 years, most of it for the better. Yet we still have a long way to go. We are still only able to manage diabetes. What people affected by diabetes really want is a cure, and we don't have that yet. But the American Diabetes Association, researchers, healthcare providers, the entire diabetes community works toward a cure every day. To view this press release online, please visit the newsroom section of diabetes.org. We hope you'll check out our timeline at diabetes.org/75 years to learn more about the advancements in diabetes treatment, management, and quality of life since the association was founded in 1940. And for the latest coverage from the scientific sessions, stay tuned to diabetes.org/breaking news and on social media using hashtag 2015ADA. I'm Rhonda Anderson in Boston.